Happy anniversary, happy anniversary, happy anniversary. Pour a cheerful toast and fill it, happy anniversary. But be careful you don't spill it, happy anniversary. Oh, happy anniversary, happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary. No, that is not me. Mr. Kapler thinks that that is me, or at least it sounds like me. I don't know. I guess.
And over the past couple of episodes, we've had a lot of people write to us and tell us they think it's you.
It's all in the ear of the beholder, I guess. I don't know. People tell me I look like Freddie Mercury, too. So, and I never saw it until people, like old pictures of me, like when I was in my 20s, people tell me I look like Freddie Mercury. And they tell me I look like John Hall of Hall and Oates, John Oates, the dude with the black hair and the mustache. I didn't ever see it until people told me. So maybe if I listen to that happy anniversary song enough, I'll hear myself in it. I don't know. But yeah, we're doing 15 years here, right, Cap? 15 years.
15-year anniversary of the Growing in Grace podcast, and as I think back on all that we've been through, Joel, and there's so much that we've talked about that revolves around God's grace, and there's a couple of things that stand out to me, not to say that they're more important than other things we've talked about, because they all kind of go together, of course, when you're talking about the gospel and not a whole bunch of different gospels, right? Just right. The gospel of grace. But a couple of things that stand out to me as far in my own mind, as far as importance in gaining a better understanding of, for me, the first one would be our discussions about the confession of sins over and over again as a believer in order to remain in God's forgiveness or in God's fellowship or whatever you want to put on that. Because that was a big deal for me as a young Christian. It was a part of, well, pretty close to being a part of my everyday Christian life, confessing sins. Obviously, you don't remember them all, so you just confess that you sinned and you're going to try harder and do better, hopefully. Please forgive me again, God. Please forgive me again. And that was actually the message I heard that got me on the road to grace was actually on that topic. And the minister that was also fairly new to the grace message, it just opened up the vault to where many of the answers to my questions had been hidden. And as he directed me away from 1 John 1:9 into a confession, one confession of the Lord Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. That was a big deal. So I've enjoyed our discussions on that. I think the other one, Joel, that we were a little bit tiptoeing on through the tulips and walking on eggshells with in the beginning of our podcast, because we felt like it might be too much for people to understand. Even when we were invited to speak at our church that you and I were attending in the 2000s, the early 2000s, where they invited us to teach like a Sunday school class, a class on Sunday mornings. Even then, I think you and I were feeling like we don't want to shove too big of a piece of meat down somebody's throat here where they're going to gag on it. Now you and I talk about these things freely because we've just figured out how to do it, I guess, or God has given us the confidence to do so because it is important. And the subject I'm talking about here is the teachings of Jesus, specifically as a launching pad for that, the Sermon on the Mount, and how Jesus wasn't really coming out with a new Christian teaching for believers to follow for generations to come. He was teaching Jewish people what the law really demanded, trying to set them up for hopelessness so that they would be able to turn to him. Because, you know, the Jewish people, they were trying to follow the old commandments from the old law. That's where they thought they would find their righteousness, their right standing with God. And nobody had ever done it, ever. And so that's what Jesus was trying to point out to the people. And this was common. I'm not saying everything Jesus said, but it was quite common. And I would say the majority of the time, the ministry of Jesus and his teachings were directed at people under the old covenant and not the new. And once you begin to see that, because the problem is if you're not seeing that, you filter everything else through that misunderstood concept that Jesus is always talking to us. And so once you begin to see it, now you can begin to see the gospel more clearly. So there's just a couple of thoughts I had as we reminisce here on our 15th anniversary.
Right, yeah. I think it was cool that you reminded me of that. We did kind of tiptoe a little bit. We just weren't sure how some of this stuff would be received, although we just said, you know, essentially, let's just do it. Let's just talk about this stuff. There was one episode that we did 9 years ago. It was February 27th of 11, called "The Unattainable, Insurmountable, Unachievable Teachings of Jesus." And on the website at that time, and I think it's still there, I'm not sure, but basically our website is hosted by Blogger, and Blogger keeps track of how many posts, how many views on each post, and all that. And it has a little widget on there where I could see which were the most viewed posts. And for the longest time, that particular episode was the most. It just remained at the top there. The unattainable, insurmountable, unachievable teachings of Jesus. So I don't know if people were going there because they were curious, or you know, because they really wanted to understand, or if they were against us or whatever. Like I said, we didn't, and we still don't get a whole lot of comments on the website. But I don't know why, but for whatever reason, even though we know that through the stats that I have on my web host, I know that there are a lot of viewers, a lot of downloads of the podcast. We do get more comments on YouTube, but it's just interesting how that thing kind of is a foundation, this whole idea that the teachings of Jesus, not all being for us, but being for the Jews who were under the law, that is really foundational to understanding the gospel. Because if you try to follow the teachings of Jesus, many of them, it doesn't mix with the gospel, the good news. It's different thing. It's different teachings, all for a purpose. But they're different things. Jesus teaching the Jews under the law for the purpose of pointing them to the understanding that they can't attain or surmount or achieve his teachings, and so to lead them to faith. That's the whole point of that. So I do like our discussions that we've had on there. Look up a series that we did called Game Changers. Go to the website, growingingrace.org. Search for Game Changers, because we did, I think, 6 or 7 podcasts in which we talked about various things that helped to change and form our thinking on things. We did a series called Covenant Confusion. That's a really good one that stands out to me. And, of course, why Jesus taught two covenants, maybe around 20 or so part series, 19 or 20 on that one. And we started off in 2005 with what is the gospel? And a very important question, God's righteousness revealed through what Jesus has done, apart from the law, apart from our works. So those are some of the things that stand out to me that we've talked about over the years.
Yeah, and so and many other things that kind of come off. They're just branches on different branches from the same tree, but some of those things were big in my life. I can remember. Like with the Sermon on the Mount, I can remember, and I might have shared this story once or twice, but the day that our pastor back in the 90s, Joel, our grace pastor, when he started teaching on this idea that Jesus, I know he teased it the week before and said, if you think that you won't be forgiven if you don't forgive, you're wrong. That's what he teased it with. Well, I think I was sick the next week because he started teaching about this idea of the Sermon on the Mount and Jesus talking to the Jews, not Christians. And my wife came home with a cassette tape of the teaching, and she handed it to me. And I'll never forget. It's just one of those moments. You talked about the moment where I told you God wasn't angry with you. Well, this was kind of like that, in that Gene handed it to me and said that this changes everything we believe. You can imagine how quickly I pop that tape in when somebody gives you a selling point like that. And it did change many of the ways we looked at things, especially as it relates to the teachings of Jesus. And you begin to see the gospel, because like what you said, Joel, some of the things Jesus said completely clash or contradict things that the Apostle Paul wrote. Just two different covenants. with the one ending at the time of the cross and the new one beginning thereafter. It's as simple as that. But and really, it was the, I guess another soft spot I have with the whole Sermon on the Mount conversations we've had, Joel, is when we were getting ready to do one again. We thought, well, let's go back and address this whole thing. And I don't remember exactly where we were. It could have been back in 2014, 2015, somewhere in there. We were going to do another podcast of some sort on the Sermon on the Mount. And I did something I don't normally do. I started writing notes because I wanted to really hit the highlights on this. And then I just thought, well, how cool would it be to maybe have a, it almost turned into like a little mini book, 10 or 20 pages on a Word document on the Sermon on the Mount. And eventually that became Clash of the Covenants, the book that's like having a Growing in Grace podcast in the palm of your hand. And I don't want to minimize Joel's contribution to the book, even though I wrote it. It never would have been written if Joel hadn't come to me and started talking about the podcast back in 2005. And of course, some of the conversations we had while the book was being written. So I won't go into that whole story, but that's how the book started to get written, even though that in the book, it's in the middle of the book, the Sermon on the Mount stuff. But that's kind of what launched it. You know, Joel, one other thing as we're getting ready to wrap up our anniversary programs here, we're unique, I think, in some ways, maybe not as unique now as what when we started, but that uniqueness, I think, is just two guys who have a heart to share the message of Jesus with people. You may not always agree with everything that we say, and that's okay, but we hope to be an encouragement to you, or at least cause you to stop and think about what it is that we're saying. But the thing I wanted to mention, Joel, is that we have not been a donation-based ministry. We're not listener-supported. We're just two guys. What minimal costs there are involved here, Joel has picked up much of that, and we're just here to try to help people. I just wanted to mention that because if you're a new listener, this is what we've been doing for 15 years, just out of the goodness of our hearts, the new hearts that God has given to us in Christ.
Right. Yeah. I think that's it. That's I think a great way to end this. Not to focus on ourselves and the fact that, but just to let people know that, you know, the costs of doing this are so low. I mean, it's like no more expensive than buying a cup of coffee every once in a while, to tell the truth. You know, to host a website and to put this out there on the internet, you can submit it to all these, you know, iTunes and or Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, all these things, Spotify, for free. And the other costs are very minimal. So we're so very happy to be able to put this out there at no cost to anyone. All you have to do is go to growingingrace.org or go to one of those places on your, a podcasting app such as Spotify or iHeartRadio or whatever, and download to your heart's content. That's really, we're so happy that it's able to work out that way and that we've been able to do that way for 15 years. So it's our 15 years. We actually did three of these. Three 15-year anniversary podcasts. Thank you, whoever you are, for listening during the last 15 years, whether you spent the whole time with us or part of it, maybe a few weeks or a few months or years or whatever. It's the Growing in Grace podcast, growingingrace.org. Thanks for listening.
This has been Growing in Grace with Mike Kapler and Joel Brueseke. Heard online through various internet sources around the world each week. To access hundreds of past programs, visit graceroots.org. Share it with a friend and listen again next week for more Growing in Grace.